arranged the organs for back to the Underscore's Daggerfall. Now, the last time we tried taking quests from Knightly Order, they actually sent us on the quest for a Daedric artifact set, and apart from this helm, which you guys probably have not seen it, we also got Auriel's shield, which has like lots of spellcasting abilities, such as resist fire and stuff like that. I don't know whether I have to use it through the use menu, or it's just available through like just a passive effect, but it's got like lots of spells in it, and it provides me with just as much of a protection as a typical tower shield does. So I thought, might as well use it. I guess I do have to use it for it to take effect. But anyway, yeah. Without further ado, let us go ahead and stick to our original intention of gaining the rank of Seneschal in the Knightly Order. So let's go ahead and talk to this guy. Well, I had felt, but I hired the fighter skill to do it. Why would you then have a fine Seneschal right in front of you? I'll be having a crisis for manpower then. Ooh. I do believe this is one of the easier quests of this game. If not necessarily easy, one of the earlier quests of this game. And, like, not this game, of like any Knightly Order, of like a traitor. Excuse me, traitor. The Knights of the Rose has been betrayed by a perfidious Nightblade. Will you help us track the cowardly villain down and destroy? Absolutely. Very good. The victor, the traitor, the traitor is a knightly named Uthard Gaerford, who has taken refuge in Trogger to the west. Is that the name of the place, or is the name of the place just Trogger? If you have not returned in 8 days, your honor will forfeit. And another will take your place. Do not fail us at this, Grimfangs. Well, that is some way to talk to Seneschal, Buster. Wait, I'm not a question, Seneschal yet. I'm just still a lowly Marshal. Not that Marshal is lowly, but you get the point. So I'm hopping on the horse because ready now to go. Trogger. Right. So I'm popping on the horse because I've heard that it actually makes traveling faster. Apparently it's a dungeon. As expected. Orc tracks, so small orcs, and they are definitely fortified from the looks of it. But given that we've been given in the 80s, this should be an easy dungeon crawl. Or so I would hope. Because the previous quest was quite lengthy and it did not give us any experience towards completing this quest either. Like, any experience towards that counts towards us climbing the ranks of the Knightly Order either. Nothing here apparently. This dungeon seems different than all the other ones that I've been to. Thus far at least. I see an Oksham. So the bad thing is I still can't equip anything. Oh wait, I could remove that. Interesting. Let me just go and equip this. And this. And this as well, I suppose. That's not hard to, right. Good thing about these, I don't need to equip these to use them, and they give me essentially unlimited potions of reaction. Or rather, they give me an unlimited amount of reaction. This is a nice touch. I don't think I've seen this in dungeon thus far. What is this thing? Why is there like a brick wall right in the middle here? At any rate, let's trudge onwards. Here we go. Let's take the right. I feel like going right these days. Like today at least. So, I'm actually recording this video right after I got Auriel shield, but I decided to separate the two because they are two separate concerns. As far as I think. So, yeah. A Daedroth? Really? Yeah, it seems these days in these Orc strongholds, Daedra are essentially, or at least these minor Daedroths are essentially a part of it. And Scorpions. Since I am heading right again. and this takes us level down. I'm curious to see what's up there, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put some blood on the ground there. This got hit hard. So yeah, I've been thinking about it, and apparently I think this, like, I've come to a theory of why these guys are hitting so hard these days. And I think it's less to do with my character level and more to do with the fact that... there's a Daedra down there, but that's not the guy that I'm looking for, so I'm just gonna bypass him entirely. This dude has nothing to fear from me, an Ox Shaman. Not exactly the person that I was looking for, but I don't mind taking him on either. But this guy did like an ungodly amount of damage, so that is really different. 312 gold pieces. But I'm hoping I can rest here. Of course I can't. Why would I be able to? I'm gonna have to take you out. I don't really want to. Oh, but then again, I have no arrows to take care of it. I guess I'll just leave you here and rest the next opportunity that I get. Hoping that I don't die before that. Nothing on the inside here. Pretty sure I can't rest here because of that damn day drop. Okay, so this is, I think, where I came out? No, this is an entirely new area. I can hear a scorpion. I don't know what the damn thing is, but I can hear a scorpion. Not the Nightblade that I'm looking for, but... okay, if it is a challenge, then the challenge is welcome. Cannot carry more stuff, do not have any arrows from me either. So I'll just let you be. As well, rather. Better drop something here to denote the fact that I have come here. I would rather not use a potion of heal true or even a potion of healing until absolutely necessary. So I would rather rest like this when I have the chance. More chance. I'll update the savior. Okay, so I came out from the left hand side. Might as well drop something, shouldn't I? Might as well, just to avoid confusions. I see two Orc Shamans. The spell was reflected. The spell was reflected. I guess that's another benefit of Auriel's shield. My god, that is amazing. That's really amazing. It seems like I'm getting lighter because I can suddenly pick up gold. Enemies nearby, not gonna rest here. Alright. No rest for the wicked, I guess. So, hey, wait, we have been here before. Oh, right. This is where we came out from. Okay. Let me put something on the ground here as well. Took a long way getting there, but as long as it gets the trick done, I suppose. Might as well keep this apple here. Unless it is an apple, right? Oh, it's a Daedra heart. Damn. Looks like a damn apple. Spiders, one hit and you're dead. I can hit, I can heal a Daedra somewhere. Probably a scorpion? No, a spider. That's a scorpion. Is that the same place with the Daedra? I doubt it is. But upon closing inspection, we have not taken the right road up there. Maybe the next time we go there, we'll go ahead and check it out. Is there anything down there? Is there? I just want to check from the other side. I don't suppose there is, but I just want to be sure. Just a scorpion. So what I'm searching for is the Nightblade, which is definitely going to look like a Nightblade. Save was a spell made. I do not know what? Who cast that spell? Ah, it was you. I see. I cannot carry anymore. Two traitors back to back. Almost right. Almost. Enemy's game. Might as well take this opportunity to see the game then. In this world. A very sad room. Woman being tortured here. 546 gold. That is nice. There are still enemies near. Probably the scorpion up there that is causing all the scorpions. All of these issues here. Yeah, I won't be interested here either. Maybe now? Yeah. Orcish has improved. So, if the enemies are not hostile towards you, they would be running towards you like that, or rather rushing towards you like that. Let us keep pressing. I'm now healed. Good. I'll update the save again. Since I am healed and everything. Now, it did say that there was this one area where it hadn't gone right. So, I guess it will keep this place here. So, I suppose we go there then. Over here. Right. So, we keep heading straight and we take a right about. And at the end of the road, we take another right? Yes. This is the area that we have not previously checked. That is one trapped pitfall that I would like to check later. Wish I could mark it on the map, but it's sad that I can't. Now, these windows are one of those things that I never could figure out how to get past when I was initially playing the game. I now know how to solve the riddle, but yeah. I doubt there's like a hidden door of or anything of the sort there, but still. I'm gonna save an emergency slot because why not? And we're gonna jump through. Okay, good thing I saved it. I was afraid of something glitching out in this game. So you don't even need to be. Yeah, you don't want to enter climbing mode with these guys. Wait, I am stuck. No, I'm unstuck now. I guess we can't jump through this one then. I guess not. I guess there is no way to get out of this. Why am I stuck here? Yeah, I guess there's no way across this one then. This leaves this little section down here. I want to jump down quickly, so let me just go ahead and save in this slot. In case it is something that's... Oh, okay. Pretty useless, actually. I was about to say in case there's something that's super powerful in there, but there's nothing there to begin with. So we have been up the stairs. And... we have not covered that area properly from the looks of it. No, we have. But we have not gone here, so might as well go ahead and do that though. So what we need to do is go up the stairs, head straight, take a left, go up, and essentially figure out what was on this side. Take a left here. Try and figure out what it is on this side. Ingredients. Thank you. Probably should have kept the bow in the... Okay, we have been here before. We haven't been to the opposite side though. The other side, I mean. From the looks of it, we haven't been that way either. So we've got two options right now. We can go this way or that way. Let's go this way first, then we can come back to the other bit. Nothing here. Cool. Now that we've marked this area of the map, let us continue on this side. Angle right here. And see where this takes us. Okay, this lot is not really here for me. Books, bookshelves. I've seen this module before. Have you been down that road? No, but the door is open. So I guess we'll just go ahead and check it out. So when the doors are open, it sort of confuses me. Because I can't tell whether I've been there before or not. Are you the Nightblade that I'm searching for? Could be. Barbarian, not a Nightblade. Too bad. I'm not the person that I was searching for in any case. This helm looks badass. I've got the same helm, but it's a completely different color. A bear and... wish I could free you guys, but... Oh well. That's just wishful thinking on my part. Can't really do anything for you. And I'm guessing this is where he slept. The man that I just killed. These are nothing. Heading up this way. I was keeping an eye on that side in case there's something there that I should be aware of. And out pops an Orc Warlord. Is that an Elven Chris? Hoo-hoo. Yeah, if I could carry that, that would sell for a pretty penny. Too bad I can't carry that. I can hear something. It's an Orc Warlord. Right. With the Dietrich Daikatana, my god. Can't carry that either. Now, the thing is, I don't exactly want to lose my Dietrich combo, so. Yeah. Let's see here. The thing about doing Daggerfall is you never know what's around the corner, so. Yeah, saving is the name of the game. You don't save, you lose. That is a day drop, that is an option. Time to play this a little intelligently. Can I take your gold? Of course, if not. But I did find my data mask on one of these guys, so they're not altogether that useless. It's better to keep checking their inventory for loot. Oh, there's something here. And I do believe this will give me nothing. That gave me nothing. Probably was a recipe of some sort. Or a potion of some sort, I mean. Nah, okay, this one I can use. Cannot carry more items. Can I? Do I have anything that I can drop? Letter of credit, of course, potion of water medium. Let us remove this and let us take this map instead. Okay. The House of Moving. Not that I'm actually ever going to go ahead and explore any of these areas, but still. Still. Nothing here. I did see a shadow, but I suppose that was my own. A lovely room for a prince, I suppose. Or a couple of them, at least. Daydrop died before we could even get off a single shot. Ooh, this is nice, a daybell. I wonder if this room is actually a human for. Okay, you can stop spazzing up now. Just a scorpion. And I suppose this is where we would have come from had we taken the straight path. Right then. As in, we are heading right then. Unless I can't recall whether there was like a divergence of the path. There wasn't. I do think this is one of the modules that I had found previously in one of the other dungeons that I'd been to. It had this exact set of rooms and also other things in it. So right now we're back to where we began. There's this door here which we haven't checked, so why don't we go and check them? We take a left and then we take a right. So this might just be a hidden door. Oh no, it's an empty room. There's nothing here. Oh yeah, right. So then, this is, I do believe this is where it came from. I don't know where this room takes me. Is there any unexplored area on this side? Does not seem to be the case. But that is still the only way down, so might as well take it down then. And then that will take us back to another place. We have not been there, we have tried going there, but we have been unable to go there. And it's not like this game has a spell of pass vault of sorts. This again comes out here, that will also take us somewhere. Have we then explored this dungeon in its entirety? I do not believe so. I do believe this dungeon would have more rooms that we can explore. Not just these many, you know. But yeah, we can take this all the way back down. This room too. The thing about this dungeon is I can't even figure out where the entrance was anymore. So this is, I think, one of the places we came out from. Okay, yeah, the entrance was somewhere over here. Nothing here. Let's head back down and check, just to confirm. Yeah, this is where the entrance is. Have we got anything that we can keep at the back of them? Probably have my bow, because I have no arrows for it. I want to remove my bow into the back of them. Alright. Now that we're here, where do we want to go next? Let's see. We have gone this way. Even though that way essentially connects to the same path. Have checked that side out as well. Nothing that we can check over there. That part takes us down into the bowels. And it leads to an empty space with nothing in it. Taking this route takes us here, which is essentially this, what's the corridor between these two rooms. These two rooms, and the only human enemy I found in this dungeon was a barbarian, right? So this is one of the areas which we have seen and we've not covered yet. So we might all have to. I think here we have, because this takes us up here. Have gone up there as well. And up here. We have gone there. Interesting, we have not gone any further in this direction over here. So maybe we can go here and check out whatever there is to check out over there. Unless we have actually gone there. Except with this thing. There seems to be something of a hidden door there which we haven't checked out yet. So maybe we can go into that way. Check out that hidden door. So how do we get there then? We take this route and we follow this path. And that will take us there. Oh, whoops. Yeah. So once there we can... Can we? Have to take this path, I suppose. You have to check these sections out. Oh wait, there's a hidden door here which we cannot check out either. So let's go up there. First we'll check out this hidden door. Maybe it'll have to have a target. If it does not, then we'll go up here and check out this hidden door. Right, let's go right. And climb all the way up. Now, where did we have to go again? We take the next left. And at the end of this room, there's a hidden door. So I should probably... be a little more mindful of the map. Don't they? Yes, this place does have a hidden door. Magically well crafted. I wonder if I can use my open spell on it. Unless there's some mechanism that triggers it. Typically, quest objectives are not hidden behind magically held blocks. Nothing there. Let me try using the. A shirt of undeniable access. Spell effect failed, really. Yeah, I mean, I can keep bashing this door and it won't open. There's a door. Nice, right here. Unless we have to kill these guys. Somehow. Saber-tooth tiger that. Grizzly bear died. Do you have anything that will help me open this door? I doubt it, but oh well. Magically held block. You come back here. Unless it's something in this room. I did not see any mechanism as such to open it, not finding fancy skulls either. Anywhere. Tell you what, I'm just gonna save the emergency slot right in front of this room. Although I do not suppose I need to, but so. Because this and the other locked door are essentially, not locked door, hidden door are essentially one of the two areas that we have not been to yet, never checked out yet. So anyway, the other door should be here, up here. And where then? Right, so it should be right here. Oh wait, it's not. Okay. Right, we never bothered to come in and come inside this room because it was a pointless room. And right, okay. So at this point, oh, it's strange. There are two of these things in this room, but it only shows one. I wonder why that is. Is that a hint or something? Trying to touch this one, that does not work. Maybe this one? No? Magically held lock. Maybe you could try using the shield again. Undeniable access my ass, because it works. So I can use the like an open spell again and again. That's good to know. Because I think when it comes to lockpicking, you only get one shot. And if you fail that, you fail it. This is a completely new area that I do not think I've ever seen anything like this. There's a nice little statue. I wonder what that did. I mean, made a sound effect of sorts. But I don't know what it did. Not as much refuge, apparently. That was the statue of a warrior, so I'm assuming it has something to do with a warrior here. Like some sort of blessing from warriors, perhaps. Might be a retainer of this. This is like an entirely different section of the map. Might as well take it. That is a Rauchi, but it's Dietrich. You can see that it's Dietrich in medieval, but it only gives you +2 boost. Which is something I feel like they could have done a better job of in this game. Is there anything here? Like a locked door of sorts, like a little door of sorts? Nothing from the looks of it. But that statue, it did something. I don't know what it did, but it did something. All of these boxes were initially meant to be lootable. Is there any other way of coming in with it? No, it does not seem to be. I wonder why this door was disguised as a hidden door. That did something. I don't know what it did, but that did something. Any hidden doors along this area right here? Cannot tell if there are any. I wonder if that opens up something for us. Some things that we previously not been to before. I can hear an orc, but I can't see them. Why did I get stuck here? Can you move please? Thank you. Yeah, I'm stuck. Okay, let's try this again. Too bad I have to scroll all the way down. Oh god. I got so many potions. Why don't they stack like they did in arena? That would have been like far better than this. Again. Wait, can I? I did not mean to intend to do that, but alright. I want to use the shirt's effects. Yeah, I can do it from here as well. It's a good thing. It opens. I need to touch the statue and come back because that seems to be the only thing that actually does anything. It makes a sound, I don't know what else it does apart from that. But it sort of does something. And since I know that it does something, might as well check it out. See whatever it does. So careful, one step at a time. I'll save you. Oh right, I was still falling active. I need to wait for it to wear off first. Meanwhile, I do not see any hidden doors or anything of that sort here. And since we've already been there and seen that there's nothing over there, this does not make much sense to actually go there and check again. But what is this here? Ooh, is that a hidden door? No, that's probably just the door that we... No, that is a different door. From the looks of it. Yes, that is in fact a hidden door. Wait, is that the door that we came through? No, it's not. It's a different place. One level down, I think near the starting. It's near the starting, and I think there's a hidden door there. Unless that's a door to the dungeon itself. Because these are the stairs that we climb out of. So this is most likely the door to the dungeon itself, but until we can verify that, since everything is going well thus far, I heard a door opening somewhere, I don't know where that was. And since I did not get sick this time around, let us head up a little cautiously. Do not want to get stuck again. Bunny hopping on steps here. Sometimes doors opening are essentially just background sounds. Nothing more to them. But yeah, other times they can actually be something. So now that I've touched the statue, I want to check out the rest of the map again. But first, I want to investigate whatever this hidden door thing is here. And I do need going back there is here. Essentially this. There are enemies nearby, maybe? That seems to me. I don't know why there's like a door. What? That's interesting. Something happened when I touched that. But anyway, let me... Yes. Grinding long boot and D-trick. And critical strike, of course. As well have improved. Now, if I'm not wrong... Yep, that's just the entrance to the dungeon itself, but I wonder why it's... this. Oh wait a minute. So on the other side, somewhere over here. Interesting. Let me go ahead and save the sword again. Nothing to get creepy here. I wonder if this comes out. Oh, okay. I don't think I've been here before because otherwise I would have killed the scorpion. Lots of chains here. I'm interested in trying to pull them. Nothing happens. These are just decorations. Nothing. That's a day job. I should die already, thank you. What now? Oh, there seems to be a trapdoor that we need to open through other means. Okay, that is... Things are getting interesting now. Also, I wonder why the game is lagging a lot all of a sudden. There's like a whole new module to this dungeon that's suddenly been unlocked. I just hope that the enemy that we here to seek isn't underneath the trapdoor here. Of course, I cannot rest here. Never thought that a game like Daggerfall, as old as Daggerfall, would lag on my PC. But here we are. Time to save. Since I'm back to full HP, I mean. Probably a scorpion being restored. No? Okay. Ah, here it is. The giant scorpion that I could hear from a mile away. Any hidden doors along the way? Does not seem to be the case. A lovely torture beam. Probably the scorpion behind the store. No, just a spider. Too bad my target isn't in one of these cages. Otherwise it would have been just ideal. Oh yeah, let me try touching them. Let's see if that opens anything up. This thing? Nah. I wonder if I have to touch that that statue down there again if I want to open this trapdoor up. Maybe we can go try that. Lag. Like, some areas of this game have lag. Makes me wonder why. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back down there and I'm going to try touching that statue again and see whether that opens anything up, because both of these areas look the same. I mean, the passage leading to both of these areas. So it might just be the case that that statue holds the key for something. So yeah, I'm going to do that. So before that, I'm going to just make an emergency save here. Maybe I should not have touched that statue the first time around. But in either case, let's go. I can hear more orcs, and I suppose that is what is underneath that trapdoor there. So, yeah, right here. We take these stairs to go up. And I'll save my stamina for now. I'll run out of wood down in case it is a timed event. We go straight and take the left of that. I killed those poor animals for no reason. I could not treat them, but I suppose it would have been more painless death as compared to starving. Let us touch the statue. Let's see if this. Yeah, that did something. That most of it did something. I don't know what it did, but that did it. Most of it did something. Good thing I saved it. Because I'm stuck again. Like, your angle while you jump up these stairs has to be impeccable, otherwise you get stuck. Saving here again. Okay, time to run. In case it is actually a timed event, I mean. I hope it is not. Usually it is not, but you can never know. You can never tell. And that is pretty much the problem with Daggerfall. Come on. Imagine running so fast with all this heavy armor on. Nope, it's not over. Oh, must be something else entirely then. I wonder what it could be. Wait, why is there... I mean, that's not a door that we can go through. Why is there that thing, that symbol over there? I just want to quickly check. Let me just save the game here. And load up the emergency save. Because I'm too busy to travel back all the way there and all the way back here, so... But here's the thing, this area has nothing, but if you go up top, if I recall correctly, this place was supposed to be a door that is bricked up, meaning it is not supposed to be, you're not supposed to be able to open it. But bricked up doors don't appear like that on the map, so perhaps we can open it. So you know, this door is bricked up, but on the map it appears as a hidden door. Oh, it's a teleporter. Okay. That's an entirely new concept to me, actually. Oh, poor Lord just died. Now I wonder if that door on the main, like the main entrance of this room is also a teleporter. Completely uncharted territory here. The beam is lagging like crazy again. Are there Daedrons? No wonder I could hear NPC. I don't know. Where is this guy? Oh, he's this way? Right. Whew. These guys are tough. This restaurant I'm beat. My god. That guy could have beaten on me. All for behind him. And he was getting Daedric stuff. No wonder I could get this so easy for him. Of course, I cannot carry more stuff. We'll just go ahead and make a safe game. Now, this makes me wonder if this is also a teleporter of sorts. Can I jump onto it? Let's try. No, it would appear that we cannot jump onto it. So I guess that teleporter is inaccessible. Unless, can we touch it? Does not seem to be the case. So brick walls, teleporters, huh? Or is it just this dungeon which where that is this? Interesting. I did not expect that. The more I play this game, the more I learn about it. Yeah, our rogue enemies though here. Yeah. It was still a fun experience though, because we were prospecting about where we could possibly go. Now there is a brick wall up there, which makes me wonder if there is some way to go, you know, access it. Perhaps. Holy shit, there is. Can I like jump out of it? Thank you. So these brick walls are essentially teleporters. That is something I have not figured out up until now. This truck is okay, somewhere. Nowhere I've been previously, which is interesting. Before I go up, I want to go towards the right and check out whatever there is over around him. Oh no, not this module. I dislike this module. I strongly dislike this module. Okay, right. That guy did a big number on me the last time around, so yeah, I decided to kill him quickly. Yeah. Let's keep going this way. Let's see where the stages. I mean, everything does come to an end, right? I see as I chuckle nervously. Of course, I cannot carry any more gold. There's an unfortunate way there, I'm not gonna go there yet. Or ever, perhaps. Spell was reflected, which is amazing. That would do good silence to his own spell. Right then. Whew. Dungeons in this game are labyrinthian, that is for certain. And the teleporter that you take does not always lead you to the same place that you took it from. This is something that I just figured out. I see another teleporter, but the question now remains is, how do we get back? Before I take that teleporter, I wanna explore this dungeon as much as possible, like all of these areas and modules. Nothing here. Problem is, we still don't know how to open the trapdoor, and our target could very well be inside the trapdoor. Now this is just a scorpion, I cannot tell from the outside, but just to confirm, I opened the door nonetheless, to check what was inside. Could have just closed the door on his face. Wouldn't have made a difference to him. Holy hell, this place is large. What have I walked into here? Maybe 8 days to solve this place? 530 gold pieces, this is amazing. Since I see it over here. Did I just walk into? My god. This place is huge. Drop the other piece there. Come on, open. Open up. A danger warlord. Sorry, an old warlord. My bad. Oh, and I found some arrows as well, which I cannot use anymore since I do not have a bow. My god, this guy has a lot of arrows. About 15 of them, I'd say. So this thing, I've seen it before. But in this case, it does not heat anywhere, so that's that. Might as well save the game, I suppose. I was wondering that the initial layout of the dungeon is comparatively very small. But here we go. It's large and everything at this point. Just like I did not want it to be. I guess it is as this AP game for what we wish for, unless it comes true. Well, since we already open this door. I have no idea where I'm gonna come out. Yikes. I'm running out of resources to mark where I've been at this point. Okay, so we have been here before. Which way did we come from, Sebastian? We took that path. Right, we have not explored this area, so might as well just explore that damn stretch. And I do not believe we have been this way yet. Not what I wanted to do. As soon as they open the door, huh? No currency whatsoever. A humanoid enemy. That's why they could open that door there. 585 gold pieces. I'll take all the gold that I will get. Wonder if I can this here. Interesting. But yeah, this holds up a bit. It gets a whole other kind of ropes. Now, I have previously tried going through these portals. Another dungeon, not this particular dungeon. It was a different dungeon, but it did not work out in that dungeon, and I did not go through it. Ooh, those are nice. I cannot carry stuff about now. That's smart of you, didn't I? Maybe some here? I don't know what that warrior statue is, but this thing, that's somewhere. That is all I can say about it, because I'm having trouble figuring out where I'm going at this part. But since we're already on top, which we have not checked out yet. Where is all this? Is something that I've heard to me. Is back the connection to that side? This piece is huge. My god, this piece is huge. Is that you leave me about in this way yet? Well, let's go up ahead. Let's go up instead. Check out what's up here. I do believe that the only thing beyond this door here is a scorpion, or rather a spider. Good thing it did not suck. I would have been pissed otherwise, but yeah, here we are. This section has also been cleared. This seems to be just a rescue team of sorts. Not the person or the enemy that I was looking for at all. I just hope that 8 days will pass while I take a tour of these pieces of this dungeon. Of this immensely huge dungeon. I don't believe there is nothing over there. That area that we just skipped past. Was there anything that we missed here? Well, there was the other side that we haven't checked out yet. I guess we will go to the other side then. I do believe we came out of here. And yeah. So this is essentially where we came out of, and this is where I'm yet to go. So let's just go and check this side out as well. Let's see where this takes us, if anywhere at all. I see. We are dead. And no, there are two parts out of here. So first off, I'm gonna check that side out. And in case that takes me somewhere familiar, I'll just come back to this one. Have you been there? Yes, we have. Okay, I can't go through this one. Or maybe I need to wait for the silence to wear off. Yes. Nope, can't go through that one. So I suppose the other viable alternative is this one. Unless we are required to cast the game out somewhere. Seems like the place with the data Or maybe it's a different base. Because I do remember clearing this area out previously when I played it. Unless that part never got saved. Nope, it's that same area. That's why this door is magically locked. Sorry, it's disguised. Because that way, we get to go out here. But yet we have not found anything there. Where did I last save? Ah, yes, right here. I sort of got concerned for a second there because I did not think that I might have actually saved at the right spot, but here we are. Come on. Come on out. Unless you want me to come in. I don't know why you overthink too when you didn't realize I was there. But one thing I'm glad about is the fact that these guys loot, they do not change. So this is why this door was disguised as such. Another view, of course. Now before I start climbing the steps, let me just go and save so that I don't warp into the void again. Since, you know, we are, or get stuck for that matter. And since we are passing through stuff these days. I will pass through that wall, that brick wall in the middle of the room there. Because sometimes these brick walls are indeed brick walls, but other times, as is now evident to me, they are actually something else altogether. So I guess it's time for us to start exploring this dungeon again and seeing where all we might have missed a few of these brick walls. Because I bet this teleports me somewhere, does not? What? Huh, interesting. Okay, I guess it's back to that room then. I'll start off with that room because that room had hit another brick wall that I could have used for teleportation, but I did not. Now, the reason I'm traveling all the way there is because... Hold up. Did this place have any brick walls? Yes, it did. It has one. Now, what I'll do here is I'll override that to see if... takes me to this here room. Oh, it takes me all the way up here without having to... But that's a bit convenient, actually. Brings me out of this coffin here, and this is the wall that I had not previously been through. Ooh, so this is essentially what we're looking for. That's nice. What is this? It's a map. Better of credit, I do not want you to move that across. Better credit. Better credit. What a waterfall. Need to parchment. Remove this. And what's this? Masterly Cemetery. I've already been there. Come on. Be a little more imaginative, you. Okay, so this probably opened up that trapdoor then. The one that we were trying to get open. Get to open. Or, I suppose get open is also not a wrong usage of words here, in this case. And, saving again. Impeccable angle required to not get stuck, and luck required to not walk into the void. This game has a very poor habit of enforcing that stuff on me. Oh yeah, right. I thought it was wrong to insult her. Time to head back to that place there. And hopefully this time around, I will be able to drop down that damn trapdoor and complete this quest within time to report back to the questor. Essentially, be able to kill this guy. Yes, it does. Awesome. Now, I'm gonna save here. The emergency slot. If only I had taken that thing initially, it would not have been such a big issue. Here's the Nightblade! You have slain Uthard Gaerford, Nightblade. Come here, where are you going? You're not done yet. That was interesting how my mana got restored completely. Even though I did not do anything. But yeah, this is the guy that I was searching for anyway. So, wow, that was complex. But even then, it was like super close to the entrance itself. So that's just Daggerfall for you. You didn't have to explore as much as you do explore. But then again, that's also a question of figuring out where to go. Which are in half the cases you don't have proper or clear idea of anyway. But anyway, I digress. So let's go. Hopefully we can still report the quest back to the quester and get our reward for it. Let me just go ahead and see if here again?
Here.
Don't want to jinx it. He did give me 8 days for this quest and I do suppose. I hope it was enough time, especially considering the fact that I've traveled back to Wayrest now. Even my horse has got sounded like a damn nightmare beast right now. Yeah, again. Today is the 30th of Frostfall, known throughout Tamriel as the Witch's Festival, where the forces of sorcery and religion clash. The Mage's Guild gets most of the business since weapons and items are evaluated for the mystic potential free of charge, and magic spells are one half the usual price. Demonologists, conjurers, lanias, warlocks, and thaumaturgists meet in the wilderness outside Wayrest, and the creatures created or summoned there may plague Tamriel for eons. Most wise men choose not to fight at this night. Very good, then. So, where are we? Right, put a pass. And report back to the cluster. That was a difficult quest. I'm hoping that the next quest will be easier. I can only hope though. But yeah, this quest took a lot of time. A lot of time. Probably because I didn't realize that these were teleportation devices until I actually walked into one of them. Just one of the ways Daggerfall is like completely throws you in for a loop, you know. You never know what is what until you actually try literally everything. Yeah. Well done. You have reason to be proud. Yes, indeed I do. After the ordeal I just went through, I do. Alright then. For meritorious service and unswerving loyalty to the ideals of the Knights of the Rose, you have been awarded the title of Seneschal within the Order. As a symbol of your fellow knights' estimation, we have elected to present you with a new piece of armor. Congratulations, Seneschal Grimfangs. Ooh, so I suppose the first quest that I did, the Daedric Artifact quest, that actually factored into this as well. That's why I had to complete only one quest instead of two. I will find this armor for you, and the good thing about this is, no matter how much stuff I have in my inventory, it's always going to show up anyway. Ooh, I leveled up too. Amazing. Wait, I thought I put 1 point in endurance already. I guess not. Yeah, let's put 1 point of endurance and 3 into speed.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm just gonna go ahead and save here. And yeah, that was that for today's video. Apparently the quest for the artifact helped us in our journey. It did count as points towards gaining the rank of Seneschal. I would have thought that it wouldn't have, but it did apparently. That's why we got a promotion with one quest in, within just one quest instead of having to complete two quests. Typically how the pattern that I've seen follows is that we have to complete two quests and then to get promoted to the next rank, and then one quest to get promoted to the next rank. Thing is, I had only previously completed quest, so like I'd recently completed quest, so it's not the case that I needed to complete another quest for this. Like I had to complete two quests this time around. Sorry, I'm unable to speak much today. Yeah, I forgot that it's free. Torgker shoes, feet of no Torgker. I wonder what that is. Peasant blouse of good luck. Constant health, check of traits. Roots of paralysis. Ooh, that is interesting. Cast for used. Amazing. So I'll just go ahead and put these back into my inventory. And I'm gonna keep them with. I like all the three effects. I'm gonna hold off those things. Even though I'm probably not gonna end up using them. But so apart from that, I do want to sell some of my stuff as well. So what do we I can go for go to sell some stuff. Let's ask them about armors and stuff. This is it for today's video. And we came here to get the rank of Seneschal. I was trying to cut my sword skills for that as well. And we have succeeded in doing so. So the next time we come back, we'll be targeting some fighter skill quests and hopefully raising the longsword up to 87? No, or is it 79, 87, yeah. We need to get this up to, ooh, that's just 3 more ranks away. 87 to be able to essentially qualify for, yeah, so the next time we come back, we'll be targeting some fighter skills quests, and yeah, hopefully that'll give us the chance to more or less just grind up our sword skills for the promotion to paladin as well. Until then, take care. This was a fun video, but farewell, fellow things.